pouring down, the Angama pride took advantage. Of course, the animals would not have been able to see them approaching, and they, I can't see what they've killed, but they've killed something. So we've just opened up the one side of our vehicle to show you the Angama pride, looking very happy. The cubs were quite full this morning, but the lionesses were hungry. Now, I'm pretty sure they used, as that big storm came in, they moved out into the short grass and took advantage of an animal that couldn't see them coming through that wall of water. Now, I don't know how long we're going to be able to stay here. There is more rain on the way, so we will stay for as long as possible. But isn't this exciting? Where there's a will, there's a way. We meandered about 400 meters from where we've been sitting, waiting for the rain to go, and the Angamas have made a kill. And it's quite fresh, I would say. We probably missed it. It was while we were sitting tight, waiting for the rain to abate, that they caught this. I think they would have caught this probably in the sort of eye of the storm. Francis from Israel says, wow, another kill. Wow, indeed. These girls have got 12 hungry cubs to keep well fed, and they're doing a spectacular job of that. Alicia says, these cats are better groomed. I assume you're comparing them to the poor Styx pride. And they're better groomed because they've got a better diet, generally, or a bit of an easier diet. A lot of the animals here will be in better condition than Juma at the moment, because it is sort of the small beginning of the small rains. There's lots of lovely green grass. So the animals that the lions are eating here are in prime condition, where there is in at Juma, you're coming right out of the end of dry season. So the animals will be suffering a little bit from condition. Ooh. There's a little bit of a family disagreement about who gets the tasty last piece of liver. Rebecca's wondering, how long will it take them to eat the whole animal? Rebecca, I can't see what animal this is, but it's probably nearly done already. There's just a pile of lions on top of it, hence we can't see what it is. Now, quite funny, some of you might have seen on Twitter or on Instagram or even on Facebook, I put up a little video of the road we took to get here. The road is a river. And we nearly got stuck while out because I was fiddling around making a video. But, well, fortunately, we managed to not get stuck. We are about halfway up the river road, and we will try and continue up it a little bit later. As I said, yeah, there is some more rain coming in. You can probably still hear the pitter-patter of raindrops on our roof. Kylie is wondering, how does the blood not permanently stain their fur? Well, Kylie, what happens is they will lick it off. Other lions will help them groom it, and it just comes off quite quickly. It comes off their fur. Now, we're quite lucky the lions have moved to where they are now. From if we had to drive the road that they were on this morning, it was we would certainly have got very, very stuck. Now, if it stays like this, we should be okay to sit here for a while. There was some more lightning to the south, but that's not where I'm too worried about. I'm actually worried about there's another big storm directly behind Final Control. So I'm hoping that doesn't come down over us.